This video tutorial describes how to manually set up and run an analysis workflow on your microarray sample data. This is done on the program's Analysis Workflow screen. Displayed on the left of the screen are the steps for setting up and starting the analysis workflow. The first step is to import the samples. The sample files can be TIFF images from the microarray scanner or feature extracted text files. Click Select Samples and browse to the folder that contains your sample file. I'm going to select this TIFF image and click Open. This dialog box is confirming that the image I am importing contains four arrays on a single slide. Click Add Images to import all four arrays. And now the samples appear in the table. The leftmost column is the global display name. This name is the identifier that will be used throughout the software. You can change it here or use the default. The Analysis Method column displays the analysis method that the program will use to analyze the sample. The default analysis method selected here is based on your mapping configurations. If desired, you can change the mapping configurations from the Configure Settings screen, but you can also change the selection here using the dropdown. This third column lists the design file that the program will use with the sample. The selection is made automatically based on the array's barcode. At this point, you can click Select Samples again to add additional samples, or click Next to proceed to the next step. We are now on the Describe Samples step. On this screen, you need to set, at the very minimum, the required sample attributes. To add more attributes to the table here, click Show Hide Attribute. And in the dialog box, move any additional attributes from the box on the left to the box on the right. By default, the green sample is selected as the reference sample. Change this setting only if you used red for the reference sample in your experiment. For whichever sample you select as the reference, the green sample or the red sample, you will need to describe that sample in the appropriate column. For CGH SNP arrays, you need to select one of the options from the drop-down list. These options are the samples that have a genotype reference file in the database that describes the reference sample's SNP genotype. If the reference sample you used in your experiments is not in this list, you need to import a genotype reference file for that sample before you start your analysis workflow. You can do that from the Supporting Files screen. When describing your samples, you can assign attributes individually, or you can import a sample attribute file that contains the information in a tab-delimited text file. For that approach, click Import Sample Attribute File and select the file to import. This dialog box shows you how the program will map the columns in your file. If the mapping is correct, go ahead and click Import. And now the attribute columns are populated with information from the file. When you are done describing your samples, click Next. The screen then displays a summary of the workflow job you are about to submit. If desired, you can edit the job name and description. When you're ready, click Run Analysis to start the workflow job. The program automatically takes you to the sample review screen, and your samples are listed in the table. Right now, the workflows are still in progress. When a workflow is complete, the status column updates to Completed, and you'll be able to review the data from that analysis. See the video tutorial on sample triage for more information on reviewing samples.